Now, this is something very important. This is more than important. UNESCO, in 2012, UNESCO is actually Malaysia is also a member. And we are obliged to follow them. So Myanmar, we are following. It's just that it's very quiet, not well promoted. In 2012, Paris OER Declaration. The declaration calls on government worldwide to openly license publicly funded education material for public use. Today, all the research that your senior and other lecturers have done, okay, all their hasil, let's say their writing, okay, they are published if possible in the Scopus and ISI and everywhere else. If you want to read it, you probably need to subscribe. You need to pay money to read the article. You know what? I, as a public, I will tell you, you know, wait a minute. Your research grant is actually using whose money? Public money. My money, you use it for your research in medicine. You use your research in agriculture. I want you to know the outcome. And then you tell me, mana boleh, tak boleh, it's copyrighted. You see, the copyright issue is not being addressed now by UNESCO. And he's saying that declaration calls on openly licensed, publicly funded education materials should be open to public use. Of course, many people say, this thing is worth $1 billion. This IP is worth $10 billion. Memang, some of them will be like that. Okay? But generally speaking, we are calling for open licensing. Okay, try to follow. Because in 2017, baru saja, UNESCO come out with the second declaration already. And it says that OER will come to mainstream education. So it's going to come across even to school level education. This is the normal copyright sign that we see. Any materials that you see available online, or anything that you do, and then you just put it on the internet online, they're all here. Walaupun you tak pakai simple ini, even though you don't use this symbol, actually it's yours, it's copyrighted. There is an understanding. Exactly. Anybody want to use your material, mesti dapat kebenaran from you. If you they don't get kebenaran, you can give them one. You miss that copyright. So, in the world of education, this is a problem. When you use something, you've got to get permission. And they might not grant it. Another one is PD, public domain. So, which means that you can use it tanpa kebenaran. You don't need any permission. Go ahead, use it. Don't even have to call my name. Public domain. In between is something called CC. And we are promoting this. All public universities are promoting this in Malaysia and in many countries. CC is Creative Commons and is under open licensing. Open licensing of any type. The most popular one is Creative Commons, CC. CC, okay, I'm going to give you a very quick brief concerning this. There are only four symbols. One is called BY. In the moment you see CC BY, it means this Creative Commons license. But if you pakai any of my video, any of my pictures, any of whatever that's under CC BY, you must attribute to my name. You must mention my name. So it belongs to you, Your name will be there all the time. Whoever you see, you will travel around the world, which is good. Increase our citation. That's what we want. Share a like. If you see this symbol, it means that if you see this symbol, it means you pakai barang itu, you must also use the same license. No derivative. It means, hey, this piece of art, you are not allowed to have new derivative. You cannot change the color. You cannot change anything that must be used intact 100%. Non derivative. For whatever reason. non-commercial, you're not allowed to make money off. When you make money, you will contact me, and maybe I ask for 80%. Really, you know, they do that. Okay. Out of the symbols, you have actually these licenses. So, CCBY, public domain, is the most free. BYSA, NC, SA. So, all these got 5 R's governing it. The 5 R means you can download the picture and you can retain it. You can reuse it, you can revise it, you can remix it, you can redistribute it. That is the flexibility of Creative Commons licensing. Up to you again. You may say, okay, I allow to use, but no derivative. You cannot change anything there. So up to you, you pick whichever one. So those that you produce later on, under some guidelines from Dr. Kendall, we encourage you to license them under Creative Commons. All these are recognized, you know, this young time, you know, by the university. So all these will be called as OER, Open Educational Resources. They are supposed to be free learning resources available on the internet. Many formats, their text, their audio, their video, their photo, anything. Today, Balik Rumah, you please go into this. This is a tutorial. 2 hours only. 2 hours tutorial. learnoer.col.org. Maybe I think you better copy this down first. You can get a PowerPoint of one, but copy this down. Register, give your real name there, because at the end, after you completed it, you will be given a certificate. The certificate, you must send it to us. You will send it to me or to Dr. Kendall, okay? If you don't, we will show you how to send. And you will only pass after you send in the certificate. Okay? This is the most important. Very good, very short, very short. And when you do it, okay, we will encourage you later on to produce your module, a telephone again. Benefits of OER, is accessible to all, and even e-books, you know. So I think I will just jump this. If you go to MIT, Massachusetts Institute of Technology, okay, almost 100% of all their materials are there now available. Creative Commons. So you can go to Harvard, you can go to Stanford, you go in. All their materials actually is open license. Share. So the culture is already there, in practice already.